Welcome to another Minecraft video. Nobues here, and you're looking around my screen and you're seeing some strange things. Besides a tree on fire because of lava lake. That one's probably going to catch on fire soon. I'm playing with a couple mods. And I've been very, very busy over the last few weeks. A few weeks. I am building a Minecraft server using these mods. I used to not be a mod person, but, well, I don't know what caused me to start using these mods. Spirion, probably, maybe. But I fell in love with them. I mean, I used to not be a mod person. And I'm using three different mods. First, I'm using red wire, and that's what these big trees are. I'm doing IndustrialCraft, and I'm doing BuildCraft. So with those three mods in mind, and a wolf jumping off of trees and dying. Okay. That's what this new series is going to be. I'm going to do this as a learning series. Because I am still learning things about the mods, as you probably are too, if you're watching this. You start off just like every other video, gathering resources and so on and so forth. Here's a rubber tree. Exactly what we need. You need rubber trees. Now I'm going to get all these confused on which mob does, which item in the game does what. Well, I believe rubber trees are far BuildCraft. You need the sticky resin to build wires. And I'll get into those later. For right now, I'm harvesting these two trees, hoping to get rubber tree saplings, which these are it, rubber tree saplings. You get rubber wood from rubber trees, which is different from this rubber wood. This rubber wood gives you sticks, and you can also burn it from coal. That's all this is good for, as far as I know. Don't quote me on that. And you get sticky resin from rubber trees. Rubber wood trees. Give me any more. What did rip off? At least I got one. New flowers. When I say I don't think, you can leave me a comment and change that. I don't think these flowers are used for anything. They could be wrong. And I also don't think these trees drop saplings. Here's another new thing. Another thing with this mod. With rubber trees. You see this little cork? I will make one right now. You have to make a crafting bench. I'm not going to show you how, because I'm assuming that everybody who's watching this has a basic knowledge of Minecraft, meaning building. Okay, you take wood planks and you draw out a faucet-looking tap. Okay, two here, one on top, and you get a tree tap. Okay, you take this tree tap, you take it to these rubber woods, and they give you sticky resin. You burn these sticky resin. No,
No.
I don't think you burn them. No. You extract them. You might burn them. I can't remember. But you make rubber out of them. And then you use rubber with copper and other wires to make wires and so on and so forth. This ash looking stuff that I'm standing on is from a volcano. I think it's part of the Redwire volcanoes. Trying to get all these. Okay. So I'll show you this volcano. If I can ever get to the top. These trees are humongous. These rubber wood trees. Whatever. That's what they're called, but I don't like that name, because when you have multiple mods installed, you got two versions of rubber woods. But I know these trees are far from the mod red wire. So, at the top of the volcano, you have this little spout, and it goes. Generally, it goes all the way down to bedrock. So, so that's a good thing. We need to find a good location. Now we're not limited to where we are, because normally the first thing you do is go and find rubber wood. Because, well, that rubber wood, then you might as well just not have these mods installed. You're gonna need them. I in particular do not like to build within a forest biome like this. These trees only grow in forest biomes, by the way, so you won't find them on a flat land or desert or whatnot. Now the rubber trees will grow where other trees are, forest biomes or not. So I want to get me a couple of these saplings. Other than that, yeah, me and Experion, we bought a server and we are currently testing it out, building it. It is going to be an IndustrialCraft server. As far as openness, we have not decided yet. The company that we bought our server with, we had a server in the same company before, and we know the server could handle this, because it's a pretty good server. But there is issues between us and the ISP, the server company, because the server we had before was in a Europe server. Well, me and Spirion both live in St. Louis, so this time, instead of getting a Europe server and having 700 pings, we decided to get a server based in here in St. Louis. The server company that we went through has both Europe servers and St. Louis-based servers. So we decided to get a St. Louis-based server. And we've been having issues with it because somewhere along the line there's a bad router causing hiccups, lag spikes, and block pop-ups. But they're working on it, and I'm confident that they will have something soon because we want to launch the server. A nice little hole to hide in. So it is going to have the three mods that I have installed on here. Which again is, I'll put links into the description of this. IndustrialCraft, BuildCraft, and RedWire. We have additional pipes also installed. Unless you do wireless wireless redstone and stuff. Not wireless redstone, wireless pipes. Sorry. Which is really good. So, you'll see later on with induction furnaces, this is gonna be awesome. Now, you're mining, you're like, oh, what's that? What's that? What's that? If you've never played this mod before, this is marble. Okay, this over here is copper. These mods introduced a few different ores. Marble is it has no practical use other than building material. You can make marble bricks out of it. Which I can show you that real fast. You need four. You don't even need a crafting bench. You take four pieces, make a square, and it makes marble bricks. So just looks and feel. I think you can make half slabs out of them too. I'm not sure. But what you can make out of them are extremely limited. No, you can't even make half slabs. I don't even think you can cut it with a jigsaw or chainsaw, whatever it's called. There's a saw that you can cut wood, that you can cut different items in the game to make different types of slabs. So, I'll show you those later. Like, instead of slabs that are half, only like normal slabs, these are up and down. So, they're pretty good. Okay, I need to make myself a stone tools. Get rid of that. And in BuildCraft, there's something called a mincerator, which pretty much doubles your mining yield. So instead of burning this down and getting three iron ore, you use a mincerator, you turn it into iron ore dust, or iron dust, and then you cook the dust. See, each iron ore will turn into two dust, and then each dust turns into one ingot. So, yeah, this is stupid. Right now, there are a couple of conflicting ores in the game. Like, there's, like, you see this? Copper ore doesn't stack. Well, these are two different copper ores from two different mines. And it was only introduced recently. So, there's a recent update that made this happen. Like, last night, there wasn't copper ore. So I think Red Wire introduced new copper ore. Don't quote me on that. So, I'm not a real technical mod guy. That's Spurion. So if you want technical details about that, you need to send a message to this channel. PM me. PM the channel, and Spurion reads those messages too, and he'll answer those questions or post a comment, and I'll make sure he answers those comments. Hey, it's a chicken in a hole. Come here, I need food. Not every day you see a chicken in a hole. So, yeah. Just waiting for it to be light out. Just mining this area dry. So, what else? Oh, back to the server. We do not know, all the details about the server. We do know one thing. IndustrialCraft has nuclear reactors, and we are disabling those to keep keep something called a nuclear bomb from happening, which happens when you you pretty much overheat the nuclear reactor and it blows up. And it makes, and it's equivalent to about, I want to say 100 sticks of dynamite. Or 100 sticks of dynamite. So, we do know that. Now, once we get a good player base and we get the good people who don't mess around, then I might consider reactivating the reactor, but as of right now, they're disabled and going to stay disabled. We're just waiting for the ISP to fix their server issue. Their lag issue, which is a broken router somewhere between us and the router and the server. So as soon as that happens, we'll announce the server. Oh, oil! Okay, well, I'm not going to dig there, because there's oil. Oil is used to power engines, combustion engines. Use those engines to for power, pretty much. They produce power. See where this is. Oh, yeah, here we go. So, this is a good area, because you need oil. Oh! I just want to see how big it is, and this tree is blocking it. So, the more, and this goes way down. Like, I wish I can put it in a creative mode Friday, guys, and show it to you, but it's really deep. When I empty this out, I will definitely show you. I can show you the hole real fast. Now this is, I can't even go down there because it goes way down. But it's deep. You gotta believe me, it's deep. I will show you how deep it is once I put a pump on there and start pumping it out. That rubber one? Nope. I kind of like this area because of all the because you got oil there, nice desert here, trees here. I just need to find my, I need to go back and get my crafting bench. I don't like to waste wood like that. Some people will just leave it there. Okay, a volcano. That's a huge, humongous volcano. And again, volcanoes go all the way down. This stuff you can make bricks out of too. This ash looking, it's kind of looks like nether brick, but lighter. So, it's. Let me show you real fast. It's a grayish cobblestone called basalt. I think you burn it down like cobblestone makes smooth out of it, and then you can make different items out of it, just like smooth stone. You might be able to make everything you can make out of smooth stone with it, but don't quote me on that. I'm sure you can't. Just poking my head around here, seeing if this is where I want to start building my base. I'm sure underneath here will be a good size cave. Actually, this little island here might work. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do it on this little island right here. Yeah, this is a good spot. Chop down these trees and get started. But with the server that we got is primarily a development server. Meaning me and Spiron are both programmers. We're not going to go into really big detail, but we needed a development server, project server pretty much, so we can keep our skills sharp. So we went half and half on the server. Well, our development needs are not that. We don't need as powerful a server as we got. But we got it because we wanted to run a Minecraft server on it. Once that server is fixed, I don't think I'm going to be doing any single player let's play anymore. It's all going to be SMP Let's Plays. Or I might continue this. I have not decided yet. There are a bunch of advantages doing single player Let's Plays. I might just keep the multiplayer over there and single player over here. It's a toss up. I could do either one right now. Got cobblestone. But as far as the server goes, we're talking about a few different options. One option that we're both toying at is charging a small one-time fee to play on the server. Now, I like this because it keeps the riffraff away. When I'm playing, I like to play. I don't like to log on and see what I just spent 4 or 5 hours on destroyed. No, I'm not like that. When I play, I want to log on and see what I spent 4 or 5 hours on still there. So, so that's one idea that we are toying with to keep those type of people away. And they generally work, because generally you're not going to pay to get on a server just to destroy other people's work. The server is going to have backups. We will not tell you how often those backups are, but they're more than one a day. And they don't slow down the server one bit. So if something happens, server crashes during the middle of the night, or just crashes and the current server configuration gets corrupt, it's no big deal. We got backups. Because with this mod, a hard crash could mean losing, and we experienced this once before. You could lose your whole entire map. So I'm just going to put all this stuff in here. See, in SMP, you don't die. I need my food situation needs to change really, really fast. So, yeah, in S&P, you go down to half, you don't die. So, single player, that's a different story now. I forgot about that. I've been playing nothing but S&P for some time now. Need to cook me up some of this food. Saying, oh, what a waste of coal. It's fine when you're getting ready to die like this. structures. Now I need to find more food sources. Oh. A chicken trap. Yay. Start off with one, that's good. Better than nothing. Gotta remember my torches. What the hell happened here? Did I do that? I must have. I'm losing it. Take some chicken. Having some chicken tonight. And I think I'm probably going to end the video here. With the same of all you IndustrialCraft people who play IndustrialCraft, BuildCraft, and RedWire, how much would you guys pay to play on a server that have those three mods installed? Now, we are thinking about charging $20 a player. That's lifetime. We have the server prepaid for like 20 years. So, I mean, we got a really good deal on it. So, we know it can play. We know it can handle the server. It's been up for 2 weeks. The only issues we are having are with the, somebody who lives in Texas that could play on the server really well. Somebody living in St. Louis will have issues because somewhere in between there's a bad connection. It's not us, it's not the server, it's somewhere in between and they're fixing it. So for me and Spirion, it's going to take us a few weeks, hopefully a few days to be able to play. But we're thinking about charging $20, and what this $20 would do is go towards a bigger, better, upgraded server so we can allow more people to play on it. Right now, we are on a virtual server. We are on a really good virtual server, but we are on a virtual server. So we are hoping to get at least 20 people evolved so we can take all that money and put it towards a new server. For just the Minecraft purposes. If you're interested in that, PM me. The price tag per slot is not set in stone. Okay, that is just an arbitrary number that we threw out, that if we can get 20 people to pay $20 each, then our server will be really, really, really good. We'll be able to hold, we'll actually be able to have development, Minecraft development servers, different type of servers, like we'll have just IndustrialCraft server, BuildCraft server, the server that we have, plus we might have a plain Jane vanilla server. But there's a bunch of different options that we're touring with. Our main one right now, we already have build it set up, it's running, just waiting for connection issues. We haven't announced it. This is the announcement. But if you are willing to, if you want to play on that server and want to give it a try, PM me. And then once we are officially ready to go live, you would either have to pay $20 to stay. Maybe it's 15, maybe it'll be 10. We have not decided yet. Or leave. So there it is. All right.